So revision day number 9, we're going to go through side headlock defense. Okay, so the good thing I find about a side headlock attack is that the fact that person really can't do you any harm per se. There's a possibility of them putting their arm around the carotid artery into something called a bulldog choke, but that is, they have to get really, really deep and they have to actually reach on the other side of the neck as well to the same arm, which is not impossible, but not many people know about it. So the side headlock is a relatively easy attack to get out of. Most of the times the person is just trying to hold you in place or trying to squeeze your head and pop it like a pimple, but it can't. That really and truly can't work. And there are many bad parts about it for that person as the attacker of which we'll go through now. So when the person grabs you with a side headlock, as they grab the head and they pull, most of the time you find that people start to fight back. And when they start to fight back, it affects the neck. Okay? So the easiest thing to do is to just go with that pull. When they start to pull you down towards them, just go with the pull and take a step with the outer sweeping leg, and you see what I mean? So as she grabs, as she pulls, I just take that step and I come forward. Now when I step, I'm kind of making like an upside down T with your legs, okay? My legs go straight, my legs go 90 degrees in either way. So your legs is kind of like an upside down capital T, right? So from here, she has been headlocked. One of the points to note is that her hands are occupied, okay? She's trying to squeeze, she's trying to hold my head, but she's not protecting vital parts, right? She's not protecting her groin, okay? Which makes it very easy for me to hit, right? That's one. Combatant, I can stomp to the toes if I needed to, okay? Most of the time, the slap to the groin is going to allow the person to slightly open their grip a little bit, especially if you hit it a couple of times, right? Open the grip a little bit. I can use my hand that's here in the back of her, bring it forward, use my other hand, make like an A frame, and push away. From here, I can hit her with a knee, okay? And the hammer fist can both run away, okay? Now, the combatants come as you see them. You don't have to put them in any specific order. I'm just giving you options. Okay? You can also do as she grabs again, as she pulls. Yeah. I can slap, slap, slap once it opens a little bit. If I feel the need to and I can run from that point. It's always nice to hit them a couple of shots just to kind of slow them down a bit. That's why I said slap A frame, be able to hit them a couple of shots and then go. Other points to note as well too is, let's see, how would I show you this? This way, right. So if Kenny grabs, pulls, okay, and I slap to the groin here, this hand is on the outside, can also, because it's a girl, if it's a guy who has long hair or any kind of hair, I can also grab their hair and pull them back, okay? If it's somebody that doesn't have hair and this isn't working too well, the hand can come over and go towards the eyes. Okay? If they have on glasses, they can hold by their ears. You can hold by their throat, pull backward, grab them, pull them downward. All those type of little movements can create enough space for you to bolt or to take off. Most of the times, I think that I would probably like to hit the person once or twice, not for ego, but just to create some type of distraction so that he doesn't bolt after me as soon as I take off, right? So, procedure again, as they grab, go with the throw, make eye contact with the hit, boom, 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 A-frame, strike, and the groin and run away at that point as well too. Lots of combatives to use, but the most important principles is go with the attack, go with the choke, and strike them in the groin because their hands are occupied. Side headlock.